The next school we have joined the RMAC in 1924, and that would be Western State College. Pat Stewart could not be here today, but representing the Mountaineers is assistant coach Brenton Elam.
Well, I was hoping that Bob would keep talking for a while because we're really impressed with those guys on film this summer as we've gone back through the league, and they're going to be pretty dang good. So I was hoping he'd give us more to work off of than that. But you guys are doing a great job. Obviously, Coach Stewart can't be here today. I'm Brenton Elam, the defensive coordinator and assistant head coach. And getting into kind of catching up on this last offseason, we finished our third recruiting class. As a staff here, our third full recruiting class. Really excited. We came here with a plan we knew we wouldn't have an instant success when we got here. We wanted to do something that would make this last for the long term. We've accomplished that, we feel like, with our players. We've decided exclusively, really, to recruit the state of Colorado. And last year we had 82 players on our roster that were Colorado high school athletes. That's more than any other team in the country. And this year, going into this season, we have 101 guys on our roster that are Colorado high school athletes. That's how we've chosen to do it. The best thing about this class is that we're not going to have to play them, hopefully. We've been playing a lot of young guys as we've tried to build this program back up. And this next year, we're going to be a very junior-heavy team, which is exciting for us. It gets me all fired up just to say that we've got that many juniors. We have some good talent, some great people, and finally we'll be going to be able to legitimately play mature, mentally mature and physically mature football going into 2009. The schedule-wise, this year we open up non-conference. We have Fort Hays coming to our place with a two-year deal with Fort Hays, and then we go to Montana. So we'll go punch them in the mouth and just see what happens. And it'll be a good experience for our guys, and excited to make that trip to Montana. And then we get into the rest of the league. Kind of summing up where we're at as a team right now, offensively, we're going to continue to be flexible. We're going to continue to play to our strengths on offense. We have some guys who can do some pretty special things in different ways, and we'll kind of need to get into fall camp and see how that all fits together, and we'll bend around the guys we have to play with. Last year, what we're excited about is our tight end position should be a lot better. Last year, we felt like we would have been a much better football team if just our tight end position had stayed healthy. That wasn't the case. We were very banged up at tight end, and this year we have Curtis Pratt coming back, who's going to be one of our better players from Douglas County High School, and he'll be a junior, third-year player for us, and he's a really good player. He can block, and he's a mean-spirited kid, and he's going to improve our tight end position a lot. We moved another offensive lineman over to tight end, Andres Alaires from Fort Collins High School, and he's another guy that doesn't maybe look like your prototypical tight end, but he's a mean kid, and he'll get a lot better blocking done on the perimeter than what we had last season. Offensively and overall, our captains are here with me today. Tyler Daniels is a quarterback for us. He's a redshirt sophomore from Random High School, and he was elected as a captain. We elect our captains at the end of spring ball, our players do, for the next season, and he was elected as a captain. And then Colin Metz is an offensive lineman from Monarch High School, and will be our other offensive captain. But neither one of them are seniors. We only have two seniors on the offensive side of the ball. We have Paul Baca, who's an offensive tackle from Fort Collins. He's going to be a senior next year. Then Darius Johnson, who's a wide receiver from Eagle Crest. Those are going to be our only two seniors. And so we're still a very young football team, but luckily this year we're playing the juniors rather than sophomores. So we feel like we got a good chance to be much improved. The other guys that stand out on the offense, Sean Sudorp is a guy we're going to put a lot of faith in. He's a wide receiver from Gateway in Aurora. Hardworking kid who's really made some great plays for us already in his career. And it's starting to be a guy we can really hang our hat on in the passing game. So we're excited about Sean. Our offensive line with Paul and with Colin, like I talked about, Scott Stoller, who transferred in from CSU. We have a lot of guys coming back. Ryan Wallstrom's a sophomore for us, who's a 6'9", 330-pound guy who is one of our top power cleaners. And he's a guy we really expect to see great things from on our offensive line. So we have a lot of good players coming back. The interesting thing about us offensively probably, though, is our quarterback battle right now. We really have four guys that are playing at quarterback right now, and any one of those four, we have a couple front runners, but any one of those four could take the offense and run it. That's been a long time coming. We've had Cameron Merrill the last 2 years, and we've been grooming these guys. They all came in together. They've all been working together. They did the scout team thing. They're all great character people. They're smart guys. Tyler is going to make a lot more money than any of us one of these days. He's an incredibly smart guy. And he and Miles Gorham from Canyon City are probably the front runners. Nick Edwards from Legacy, and then a kid that transferred in from UNLV as a freshman, redshirt freshman. Those four guys are all battling. They can all do it. And what's unique about them compared to Cameron Merrill is they can all run a little bit. So hopefully that allows our offense to maybe open up a little bit more and use a little bit better athlete at that position than what we've had in the past. Defensively, we have five seniors coming back on defense. Omer Tamir is the only a guy in the front seven. He's the only senior. Our whole front seven will be back for a couple of years. Omer Tamir played nose for us last year, and he's going to be a senior this upcoming fall and a really, really special athlete, we feel like, in the defensive line. Jason Asana is a safety. He'll be coming back for his senior season. He's a transfer for us last year. Missed a lot of the season with injury, but he's a guy that had as good of a spring ball for us as anybody, and we expect him to really play well. And then we have three corners that are going to be seniors. Brendan Zink, which is one of the only guys that we had inherited that's still in our program. Zink will be a senior. Davion Rogers and E.J. Gillespie from Horizon High School. Those guys will be our five seniors on defense. Our captains on defense this year are Zach Rayford, who's a linebacker from Boulder, and Blake Krenke, who's a linebacker from Pomona High School. Those are our two captains as voted by the team. Some other guys, we hope to be a lot better on defense this year. As the defensive coordinator, I really pray that we are. We've got some really good people, and we've been invested in those guys for a long time. And we feel like Trevor Bobb, that linebacker from Doherty here in Colorado Springs, is a guy who maybe has a little bit different skills than everybody else we've got. He played safety last year, moved him into linebacker this spring, and he's going to be a guy we really expect and need to carry a big load for us defensively. Levi Ostrom, a defensive end, is another kid that from Faith Christian High School in Arvada that I think he has as much skills as anybody in our league, athletically and physically. He's been banged up a lot through his career so far. He'll be a junior this year coming up, and we really expect to see some great things from him. Nick Zismos, the guy up front that we expect to play well. We have some great linebackers, some guys that are going to be junior college transfers, one that came in and redshirted for us, Mike Reynolds. He'll be a starting linebacker for us this fall. And our safeties, Marshall Wallen, DJ Hughes, some of those guys. They're just great kids. They're good students. They're good character people. They're tough. You know, Western State and Gunnison is a tough, blue-collar, proud place. And that place has won 19 conference championships over the last 50 years or so. And they are proud of their athletics. They're proud of their sports, and they want to win. And we've really set in place a great plan, I feel like, over these last 3 years to put this program where we want it to be in terms of being a mean-spirited, blue-collar, physical program. And we have great kids, and we're looking forward to showing them off this fall. Thanks.